All right, welcome everybody to the Spread Your Heart channel, where we come together to spread the love, spread the space, and spread your heart. I am here with
Geo Cartel,
everybody.
AKA Brandon.
Geo Cartel, the one and only.
What's up, you?
My favorite of all. He is here today with me. We're gonna do like a little chit chat, kick it, story time. You know, we're gonna let him have the platform. You know how we do on Spread Your Heart. We let our fellow friends and buddies have our platform. You know, we open the floor, because whether you got something to say, you don't have something to say, you just need somebody to talk to, we are here. So this is my homie, right? So I want to tell you guys a little bit about Brandon. So me and Brandon met, it's almost been 2 years. Okay, we have known each other for so long.
3 years.
So we met our mutual friend Jermaine. Shout out to Jermaine. The cat. He had a cat, and it was this whole situation where he moved. Remember, Cody Kitten? And I had to come pick the cat up from your house.
Okay, we got that rekindled.
Yep, that's what it was.
Okay, so we had a friend that moved out of state.
Yeah.
And he had two animals that he needed a home for the time being that he was gone. And I volunteered to take in the cats because he's a great friend to me. So
exactly.
He did everything for me, and I will do the same for him. And as we kept in contact, he moved away. And at that time where I couldn't keep the animals,
mm-hmm.
China stepped in and took care of the animals.
Because you know, we love animals this first.
We definitely love. And then
she had cats.
She took in Alto, she took in Cody Kitten.
I took
Kins.
In their pets for them when they were going through that transition.
Yeah.
And that's how we met. We saw each other and we had each other's number, obviously,
yeah.
Because we had to meet to get the cats. So we met, and then I think we needed. Something else came up, and then we ended up just keeping each other's contact, kept going back and forth.
Something happened in my life where I had to move, and she took in animals. So as I was moving, going through my struggles and my tributes, we kept in contact.
Yeah.
So at the time that I needed her, she answered the phone.
I did.
She picked up the animals.
I did.
And she was like, you know what? We've been cool for this long. I got a spot that you can come and stay at. So I moved in with her.
Oh my god.
And that summer of 2019 was.
Bitch, who the fuck you think you're talking to that? Get the fuck out.
Oh. Shut up.
That's literally how it was. That shit took us from.
That was
we
a very
happy down.
Summer.
We were happy one moment.
We went
down
through so much together.
Yeah.
It was just like everything was going great, and then boom, one of us would crash and burn, and we would take turns crashing and burning.
Yeah.
And then we would need each other every single
and
time
we
crashed and burned.
We were literally there. We were right next to where she needed. We were crying to each other.
It
we fed each other.
Roommate.
We were broke with each other. We were homeless with each other. We ran out of gas with each other.
And somehow, during all these struggles, we still managed to club. We partied.
We still went to the club, though. It was free. We knew each other.
It was free. We didn't pay for hardly anything.
Well,
a lot of people
hooked
us up, too.
Yeah.
We had a lot of hookups.
Yeah.
You know, you meet people.
Socialize.
Rooftop party. Remember that rooftop party, and I wore that fur and the grill, and I thought I was cute?
But we left early because it was so lame.
It was a mess, and we had a lot of fun. And we went through all this wild stuff together, and it brought us closer together.
It definitely did.
And it's crazy. And what's funny is how we came together, because neither one of us are even from Washington.
No, I'm from Arkansas.
He's from Arkansas, and I'm from California. And then we both moved here at different times.
And eventually, good things made us link up, and this friendship could continue to go for years and years, and nothing will change at all.
Not at all.
Even when she's going through her struggles, I'm still here for a year.
Mm-hmm.
She's here for mine. We boost each other up, inspire each other. She's doing her YouTube channel with her thing. I'm trying to get mine started, which you guys can follow, by the way. I'll give you a link later on. And so it's just we're very much similar, just different zodiac signs.
Wait, he's an Aquarius. And I'm a Taurus. And somehow we compliment each other.
Well, we definitely made it work. We cried. We shared a lot of
that.
And this is a relationship that you just can't break.
Exactly. And if you have good people by your side, you gotta keep them close, because I know sometimes when you're going through something, it's easy to shut others out and just want to go through your madness by yourself. And you don't want to deal with that. But I'm telling you, you are not alone, and you are never going through something alone. And you never know. You reaching out to somebody else just as a shoulder to lean on and support could be the best thing that happened to somebody else that also needed a shoulder,
yeah,
and brings you two together, and you guys could be supporting each other, you know. So don't look at it as like, I don't want to reach out, I don't want to be, you know, in a way, I don't want to feel like somebody's burden, you know. Don't think of it like that. Think of it as you helping another person help you.
But if you're that type of person like me where you need to take a step back from everybody and just go low key, you know, just do things by yourself. If you can think on your own and you don't need no friend, that's perfect, because I'm the same way. If I need to sit down and get my shit together, I'm literally gonna sit there, turn my phone off. I might ignore a couple of friends, which I do now.
I apologize.
It's just when I'm in this set motion, I'm literally in this set motion. So if you just have to take a step back and just reflect off yourself, figure out what you want to do in life. At this point, the quarantine is going on. This is the perfect opportunity for us. Nothing open.
Perfect.
To get what you want to do.
Man,
you know, to do what you want to do.
We've all been sitting at home since March.
Y'all gonna have a business started. You bitches better learn how to. This time, everybody should learn a trade. Everybody should learn how to work on cars, photography, learn how to make belts. You learned a different language.
Also bored during quarantine. We were just doing some random stuff. I done picked up gardening, all types of stuff. Just random stuff.
And I'm starting to make pieces that I don't know how to sew. So I'm just learning as I go.
Exactly.
So new trends.
And share your new things with your friends too.
Literally.
Because they support you. Be like, Randy, guess what? I just made this scarf. I made a scarf.
Postman to give it to the homeless man, but she left it in the damn apartment.
I did. It was
so with that
mess.
Being said,
somebody's gonna get the scarf. I promise.
Somebody's gonna get the scarf.
We're gonna have that. Okay.
Oh Lord, Jesse made another one.
Huh? Pack in the mail, it's gone. She like I smell cologne.
Yeah.
I just signed a deal, I'm on. Yeah, yeah. I go where I want,
good.
Play if you want, it's do it.
Huh.
I'm a young CEO, sure, yeah.
Drug lord Griselda, I used to move weight through Delta. So stay in your place, cause I don't wanna put you in a shelter. I'm cooking up in the kitchen, you could be my little helper. Queen sleazy era, and they never see me ever. Cause I send my shooters and they introduce us as soon as I pull a lever. I say choke me, he do it, every time that we do it. Nigga packing like Hewlett, I told him damn nigga Hewlett. On that D going stupid, got my ass shots from Cupid. You could just ask Ken, he'd be like, oh, I do it.
I cannot, but yeah, I am so glad you are here, and we are all going through so much, and it's just been
still going on, crazy.
You know, things are getting better, but just as far as in the world and the atmosphere, you know, COVID is still a thing, so everybody, please still be safe.
Please.
The fires, if you are in the Western region,
please stay safe
from the fires. No littering. If you litter one, it damages the earth. Who litters? And two,
don't throw no cigarettes.
We're going to light things on fire. So please keep your trash in a trash bin. Please wear your face masks, because we do not want to spread germs. Or I don't want you inhaling the ashes. And if you are someone,
asthma.
Man, if you got respiratory issues, that air is no joke. And if you are my East Coast homies out there, my Southern homies, stay safe in those hurricanes.
Please.
I couldn't live in the South. I'm sorry. Let's just put that out there right now. I don't know how y'all lived in areas with really bad, like, extreme. I don't want to say that, because California is bad with fires, but I'm going to let y'all know right now. Being a California girl, I've never been in a fire. I've never had to.
I've never had to stop, drop, and roll. Yeah.
I've never had to get under a table from an earthquake, because people be like, California earthquakes, it was a 1.2. I didn't even feel it. I be asleep.
Arkansas don't have nothing but big ass mosquitoes and a bunch of floods.
The only parts of California that have that extreme is, like, you know, I think like northern, if you're closest to like the San Andreas Fault, then you get that. But where I was in SoCal, I never experienced that. It's just extreme heat and smoke. But if you live in the South,
every day.
Imagine literally living, having to, like, the tornadoes.
We had a couple of hurricanes.
Like, I've never been in a hurricane. I've been in a storm when I've been in Virginia with my grandma, but I've never been in a hurricane.
The last one we was in, I was so young. My mom used to stay away from the glass. We all was in a corner with a blanket, and that was it.
What?
I fell asleep next day, and you know, I was in a bunk bed, and mom was sweeping the floor.
So pause. because how did you get from Hurricane Arkansas to rainy Washington?
So I moved here due to my aunt. She's in the military. So since at the age of 12, me and her and my other brother has been shifting from state to state just to stay in a different culture type of environment for us, because Arkansas is really just African-American bound, if that makes sense. And not really too cultured, but cultured, if you know what I mean. Mm-hmm. More street smart and educated.
Yeah, and in a very urbanized area.
Lucky for me, I was raised to have both.
Should have never let a nigga be good up in this nigga, let me be in this nigga, let me not look at the whoop.
That's all he's saying too. That's all he's saying too.
I don't know what he's saying.
We moved up here in 2007 or 8 with the school and just been moving back and forth. So Washington, just after graduation, Washington was the home to me.
It must have been a big culture shock.
It's very much different. You don't see that many Caucasians. They were in their side of town. You don't see that many Filipinos. You don't really see that many Asians. You really don't see that many cultures other than African Americans and different ethnicities. You don't really
Moving to Washington has expanded my friend group. You know, a lot. I've definitely become more diverse in the people I talk to in this area. Only because, one, you're kind of forced to. I'm not going to be a hermit. I mean, that's racist. I'm not going to do that and be like, I don't think black people. it's really crazy. I've met so many different people out here. Especially do you remember when we went to Pride? My first time going to any type of Pride festival was out here with Brandon. We did Seattle Pride. Yeah.
It was last year.
We went to Seattle Pride. Oh my God, I had so much fun.
We will save that for another story, because that's something that we gotta.
I had a really great first Seattle Pride experience.
It was very hot, very packed. You saw a lot of fashion, LGBTQ culture.
Yeah, shout out to my LGBTQ community.
So it was definitely a different scene. And if anybody that's from the South and wants to move to, Northwest, East, get the hell out of the South, just for a month, or if you have family that's out of state, try to go and experience different things. Life. Because if you've never done it, you're gonna be at the age of 40 like, damn, I wish I would've.
Right. Talk to that person. Like, make those crafts. Talk to that person.
Young Money. Ayo, Ferg.
Yeah. Ride with the mob. Alhamdulillah. Check in with me and do your job. Ferg is the name, Bimbola did the chain, Tono for the watch, Prezi plain Jane. Yamagini chain, rest in peace to my superior. Hermes Linga feed a village in Liberia. TMZ taking pictures causing my hysteria. Mama see me on BT and start tearing.
Hey, yo, I'ma explain why you probably never see me. I push a Lamborghini, choke your magic like Houdini. My body shaped like Genie, booty dreamy, waist is teeny. Yes, I told him to get titles so he stream me when he leave me. I go hard in the booth, Biggie vibes, give me the loot. I'm a classy millionaire, bitches ain't got the coof. C-O-U-T-H, cause you can't spell it either. If I call him, then he coming home, running Derek Jeter. Bitches must be eating ass because I swear it by them feeders. Ho, you know that you my son, I should've scrapped you as a feeder. Rap bitches, they gotta check in with the queen. I'm the alpha, the omega, everything in between. Ride with Minaj, mashallah. Check in with me, then do your job. Queen is the name, Raffaello did the chain. This is Monse, Patty Plain Jane. Eat a Barbie ass or something. Eat a Barbie ass or something. Eat a Barbie ass or something. Eat ass or something.
And that's what, like, I think that's the biggest thing too that people have to remember is that even though you're going through something and sometimes it feels like you probably just want to be alone, you want to shut everybody out, you feel like no one's going to understand, you feel like you don't want to throw up your problems on people or be a burden.
What the fuck?
You have to remember that sometimes it's good to reach out to people and one, get it all out. Yeah. There's always one person that you can relate to. Get it out. And you could be helping that person too. You could be, you know, that uplifting spirit for that other person. So don't be afraid to reach out to somebody, a family member, a friend. Sometimes you meet people at the grocery store and Bob the bagger ended up being your best friend.
It's a small conversation and that can go so far.
It can go so far. You can make somebody's day. I remember this one time I went to the commissary. I went to the grocery store and the bagger, she seemed like she just had like really social like anxiety. And you know how people just get to talking and talking, they just seem like just like tell their whole life story.
Yeah.
Just right then and there, like based on meeting you.
Yeah.
And she was going on and she was like, yeah, just going on, and she was so awkward, telling me about this boy she liked, this guy at church, like she was going on, and I was like, and I could tell she was trying to do it from the person that was in front of me too. And the first lady was like, and just like grabbed her change and left. But I was like, really? Oh my God. I don't know what this girl was talking about, but I was like, yeah, oh my God.
Yeah.
And then when I got my receipt, she was like, she just looked at me in the eyes and she was like, thank you for talking to me. I know I probably took so much of your time, but thank you for talking to me. And I was like, no, it's okay. And I kept going, I'm so good.
I think walking in Seattle, you definitely talk to a couple of different people that you would then talk to in a normal everyday circumstance. Mm-hmm. But there are really good people out there to talk to.
And
if you're the type of person that actually keeps yourself,
exactly,
you know, get your thoughts together, reflecting yourself, that's a good help. That's a good strategy as well. I'm that type of person that likes to just take a step back from social media, reality, family, friends.
Don't give up on humanity.
Just focus on yourself.
Yeah.
All the shit that's going on right now, you guys have plenty of things to do, such as quarantine. There's nothing to do. There's no stores open, no clubs, no bars. So it's a perfect time to get you a craft started, or learn how to sew.
It's not too late.
Learn how to make a garden. I didn't came up with so many ideas that I can make.
I've been
right
doing
now.
All types of random stuff around the house. Just looking crazy up here trying to paint. There's nothing
literally
to do.
Nothing to
this
do.
Is the perfect time if you just have a lot going on in your head. Pour it out into something that's productive.
You sing, you
whatever
rap,
you
want to
do.
Fashion, photography.
And if you have something you want to do and you want to let us know and bring it on a channel, you can hit us up, DM us, Instagram us, hit us up on whatever platform and send us your work and we can shout you out for the Spread Your Talent segment. But that's another story. Anyway, you know, it's just a really great time to seize the moment. And we want everybody to remember that. And we also want you guys to remember to bring your friends along because you're probably helping them too. You know, you have somebody there, put your friends on, put your homies on.
One person might know how to do each other video on. Editing.
Guys,
somebody that might know how to do
exactly.
Fashion styling.
You
so
guys can inspire
each other.
That's
exactly
so that's what
we're
here for. It's mm-hmm. great to inspire each other.
Because I got a text message from her the other day asking, hey, would you like to help hand out stuff for my organization?
Yeah.
Without a hesitation. Yes.
We did our tent homies. We did our donations. If you want to see that video for the tent homies, which was so much fun, mm-hmm. I will leave a link card or the information in the description box, and you could check out the other video that we did with Rodessa and Catalina. That was so great. Yes. Oh my God. We had so much fun today.
Yeah.
We just kicked it. We look good.
Bomb.
Everybody for watching the Spread Your Heart channel, our little story time fun with me segment with my friend here Brandon. If you would like to see more of our videos, go ahead and check out the Spread Your Heart channel story time segment. I have my own little personal channel going on too if you want to check that out, the China Monroe. Just China Monroe. And then you can also follow me on Instagram at, I'm gonna get it right this time you guys, at @ChaiBC_sharp. Got it. And where can they find you, Brandon?
They can find me on Instagram at @GeoCartel. Same as Snapchat, Facebook at Brandon Jenkins. YouTube coming soon at GeoCartel.
Yes. All right, everybody. See you next time.
Thank you guys.